Unboxing of the, as you can see, the Losi LST XXL 2. It's a 1/8 scale, two cycle gas powered. It's kind of like a, spinning around here. It's kind of like a nitro engine. It is basically a nitro engine that's been set up to run on at least 91 plus octane. So, got here, I've got my 1 gallon of 93 octane gasoline. I've got bought a couple of extra of their little Dynamite brand pre-mix oil. Each of these treats up to 1 gallon, or actually treats exactly 1 gallon. So got two of those, already got me some pre-mix mixed up. Quickly go over the features. Got your red anodized aluminum chassis. Of course, it's the LST XXL platform. You've got your ultra durable red anodized oversized shocks. You've got some huge shocks on it. You've got the 0.31 dynamite cubic inch gasoline engine, 300cc capacity fuel tank, AVC, which stands for active vehicle control receiver, waterproof servos and receiver, and a complete ball bearing set in the truck, four wheel drive. You get a Dynamite 2S 2000 milliamp hour LiPo for the receiver and the CDI ignition. Comes with two-speed transmission, tune pipe, spin start, roto start system, 420 series force wheels, got the black chrome finish on them, and the 420 series ATX tires. So, the box on each side has two seals. It says do not accept if seal is broken. And unfortunately, this box here that I got, this particular one, for some reason, the seals were broken on this end. So, and I didn't break them. So I don't know if it was from just movement shipping or not, but I peeked inside and it doesn't look like anything was messed up or been taken out. So I guess it's okay. If we can get this big joke right here. I have noticed we've got a happy mockingbird in the background, so not much I can do about that. I just wanted to do something a little different. It's a nice day out, doing outside unboxing. Wow. Tires are hard to get out of there. Looks like we got our receiver packed in the side over here. Or transmitter, sorry. Comes with the DX2E Spectrum radio. Got your power, throttle trim, steering trim, and then your active vehicle control is over here. You can turn it all the way up. You have a rheostatic adjustment on it, and you can also turn it all the way off. It's like a pretty nice little radio. I've seen other people say that the throttle, the input on this right here, the resistance is really light, and it really is. It's really easy to pull. I do notice this handle's not quite popped in. There we go. It just popped right out. It's really light. It feels honestly a little bit on the cheap side, but I guess we'll see how good it works out for me. Nothing in that side. And looks like we've got some zip ties on the bottom. Tying it to the bottom. Heavy, about 14 pounds is what the total box weight was. And the truck itself, I'm not sure. Yeah, very nice suspension, and these shocks are huge. Pretty good sized tires on it. Yeah, it's got some nice suspension on it. Nice looking body. Give you a good look of it around. See if I can get a good look of it.
I like that little, can't see it very well, it says unleaded in the back. That's pretty sweet. Alright, let's get the body off this thing and take a look under the hood. Make sure I'm still recording. There we go. The body is pretty thick body on this thing. It seems like it's a good quality Lexan. It's pretty thick. It's a lot thicker than your definitely a lot thicker than your average tent scale body. Seems like a good sturdy body. And it sure is a good looking truck. If I can get up close. Got your 300cc fuel tank. 0.31. That's a big, huge cooling head on that joker. Dynamite 0.31 engine, your tune pipe, got your CDI box, got your Spectrum S601 throttle servo and brake. Looks like it's got a dual setup, throttle linkage, and then a like a squeeze disc type disc system, brake system. It's your this is your slipper clutch and two-speed. It's got two gears on the clutch under here that do the shifting, you know, for the when it changes gears. Let's see if they can get the pin out for the receiver box. Neatly packed in there. Your Spectrum SRS 4200 receiver. That's your on-off switch over here. It's hard to put these shocks into perspective on there, but I mean they're as wide as two of my fingers, as you can see. You know, they're two fingers wide, so they're a good size shock. Picture underneath. Here's where your LiPo battery goes. You got a steel dog bone drive line. From what I've heard, the the transmission is a all steel transmission. You got your dual steering servos. They are Spectrum S601s. Let's see if that's the same as what the throttle is. Yeah, they're all three the same exact servo. As you can see, the differential cases are in fact red anodized aluminum as well. The actual differentials themselves are plastic though. The housings inside are plastic. The kind of hard to get a shot of that, but the dog bones here are a good size. They look to be about 4 millimeters, about 5 millimeters probably. I'm not sure exactly, but I'm just taking a guess. CBD style. Looks to be of excellent build quality for sure. I'm gonna take the camera off the tripod and give you a up close look of it. Soon I'll when I get into it, I'll try to put another video up of under, take the little cover off, let you see the slipper set up, all of that. These wheels are pretty, boy. They've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 small socket head cap screws that hold on a like a hubcap, if you will, and then your wheel nut is underneath that. So one good thing about that is if your nut happens to come loose, at least it's going to stay contained in that wheel hubcap. And the tires are a little bit wider than my hand. They're pretty good size. Can't wait to get this thing out and get it broken in. I gotta go to work here in a little while, so I won't be able to do it today, unfortunately. I'm gonna open this box up right here, try to do it one-handed and show you guys what all comes with it. All right, you get two
two bottles of small bottles that treats up.
All right, so here's what's in the box. It comes with it. You've got your two small bottles. Each bottle will treat up to a quarter gallon of gasoline, so you've got enough to mix up a half gallon to get you started in the break-in process. You got your roto start tool. Pretty good size little tool. Got a Tamiya style battery connector, which I'm probably gonna have to swap that out for Dean's. Everything I've got that's nickel metal hydride, which is what it takes, is a Dean's plug, so I'll probably swap that out to a Dean's adapter. You got your tool, your bit inside the battery tray, which is a neat little feature. Set that aside. Let's see what else we got in here. You got your manual, instruction manual, and decals. Looks like we got some sort of tool here, multi-function tool. I'm really not sure what that is, honestly. You got a four-way lug wrench. You got your Allen wrenches, just basic little small hex keys. Another little wrench. You got your bind plug to bind your receiver to your transmitter. And then you got four nice Sony batteries to start you off in your transmitter. And this is your, it's a 5C 2000 milliamp hour 2S 7.4 volt lithium polymer battery. And that will control your CDI box, your ignition, and your servos. So I'm not sure. I don't think this truck comes with any kind of a LiPo alarm or a low voltage type deal. So I'm not sure. I would think you'd probably, I've heard people say that you probably good for two tanks and may not want to stretch and try to get a third tank out of this LiPo, but I don't know. I think I would probably have to just check it after one tank and know for sure. I would think you for sure would get one tank out of it, I would hope. I know if you push these things too far and they don't have a LiPo alarm or any kind of low voltage cutoff, you could risk even starting a fire or ruining your, not so much starting a fire, but just damaging your LiPo and messing it up if you run it too low. So, but anyway, guys, I appreciate you guys watching. Like I said, be expecting me to, I'm definitely going to be doing a series on this truck. Start with the break-in process either tomorrow or Monday, Saturday afternoon right now. And once we get that going, I'll be sure to get that on film, get all the break-in, we'll see, and we'll learn this thing together. It's nothing like nitro. It's similar, but the adjustments and stuff, your high-speed needle and low-speed needle settings, it's different because it's a gasoline-powered. So I'm going to learn this thing together, figure out how to get her tuned in well, and see where we go from there. But appreciate you guys watching. Have a good day. See you next time.